we're going to talk about the RepRap discount full graphics smart controller on the Bigtree Tech SKR version 1.4. Now, I need to point out a couple of things to you. First of all, the port for the RepRap we're going to be using are these. So you have EXP1 and EXP2. On the actual LCD, you have obviously your LCD. You have your dimmer that you'll probably never use. Then you have your reset or stop button, a piezo buzzer, and then you have a knob to select menus by turning and pushing. Now, keep in mind, no one is paying me or sponsoring me to do a tutorial. I purchased all the goods for this tutorial with my own money, but I will be placing Amazon affiliate links in the description. On the back side of the graphics controller, we have our EXP1 and our EXP2, and then we have our SD card reader. So to connect this up, what we need to do is we need to take a ribbon cable. So the ribbon cable looks like this. Now it's going to have notches on it. So you're going to connect EXP1 with the notch connector. And then you're going to connect the other side to EXP1 on your SKR. Next, you're going to do the same with your other notched connector. You're going to connect EXP2. And then you're going to connect EXP2 on your board. Okay, now that we have the USB set up and ready to go with the TF drive in the port, we need to connect the big side of the USB connector to our board. And we need to connect the small side to the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. And if you hooked it up correctly, you should see that the LCD lights up. Okay, to start with, I need to show you that the firmware from the last build and the date and time. Now I'm going to go over to VS Code. Now I already have the actual firmware open. They now have 2.0.x that contains the information for the SKR version 1.4. So I'm going to show you that real quick. I'm going to go to source, core, then I'm going to go to boards.h. And as you can see right here, it says board underscore Bigtree underscore SKR underscore V1 underscore 4. So we're going to copy that. Then we're going to close out of that. And we're going to go to configuration.h. And we're going to do a search on motherboard. And we're going to replace board underscore 1. Pardon me. We're going to replace board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB with what we just copied. So we're going to paste it here. And we're going to scroll up and we're going to change the serial port to -1. Then we're going to do a search on LCD and as you can see, it's LCD and SD support. So they have a bunch of languages here that you can choose from to set your language, because right now it's default English. If you want to change it to, I don't know, Deutschland, Polska, Ruska, or Francais, you can use the two letters here to substitute it in for the language of your choosing. Now keep in mind, they also have a test language that will allow you to make your own language if you so choose. Now scrolling down, they have different types of fonts that you can work with, being Japanese, Western, or Cyrillic. But we're going to skip over this for now. Now they also have different types of LCD displays, being Classic or Prusa. And then, of course, we have an SD card that we want to support, so we're going to remove the comment Now keep in mind, if you have any issues with your LCD, you can remove the comment for define SD check and retry. Now I'm going to skip a lot of the functionality in here because you can read it on your own. And we're going to search for the RepRap Discount Full Graphics Smart Controller, which is down here someplace. So here it is. So in order to set it up, we need to remove the comment. And then we need to go over to platform.io.ini. And I've already changed the default environment. But originally it was the Mega 18 Mega 2560 for the chipset default. But we're not using that. We're using an LPC 1768 as our chipset. So in order to compile it, we need to press the upload button, which will compile or build and then upload to our board. So I'm going to press that, and in a few moments, we'll see what happens. Okay, now that we know the compilation just finished in just under 3 minutes, we can double check to make sure that it's okay, and it looks like our chipset, being the LPC 1768, was successful. So let's check the SD drive to make sure that it made it there. Looks like firmware.bin has made it there. So as you can see, the date and time of the actual build, I'm going to remove the USB in order to connect it and show you what happens in just a moment. So I'm going to power it down. And now I'm going to power it back up with the LCD displayed in the bottom left-hand corner for you. And let's see what happens. So it's coming up with the LCD displaying the actual version being 2.0.1. And the firmware looks like it's just updated. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.